Good morning and welcome to Morning Prayer on this glorious Saturday morning. Love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O shout to the Lord in triumph, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good. His loving mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life, which you have made known to us in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 95 and 88. Psalms 95 and 88. Psalm 88. O Lord, my God, my Saviour, by day and night I cry to you.
Let my prayer enter into your presence. Incline your ear to my lamentation.
For I am full of trouble. My life is at the brink of the grave.
I am counted among those who go down to the pit. I have become like one who has no strength.
Lost among the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave.
Whom you remember no more, for they are cut off from your hand.
You have laid me in the depths of the pit, in dark places and in the abyss.
Your anger weighs upon me heavily, and all your great waves overwhelm me.
You have put my friends far from me. You have made me to be abhorred by them. I am in prison and cannot get free.
My sight has failed me because of trouble. Lord, I have called upon you daily. I have stretched out my hands to you.
Do you work wonders for the dead? Will those who have died stand up and give you thanks?
Will your loving kindness be declared in the grave? Your faithfulness in the land of destruction?
Will your wonders be known in the dark? Or your righteousness in the country where all is forgotten?
But as for me, O Lord, I cry to you for help. In the morning, my prayer comes before you.
Lord, why have you rejected me? Why have you hidden your face from me?
Ever since my youth, I have been wretched and at the point of death. I have borne your terrors with a troubled mind.
Your blazing anger has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me.
They surround me all day like a flood. They encompass me on every side. My friend and my neighbor, you have put away from me, and darkness is my only companion. Psalm 95. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms.
For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods.
In his hands are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also.
The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land.
Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
Harden not your hearts as your forebears did in the wilderness, at Meribah and on that day at Massa when they tempted me.
They put me to the test, though they had seen my works.
40 years long I detested that generation and said, "This people are wayward in their hearts. They do not know my ways."
So I swore in my wrath, "They shall not enter into my rest."
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Job, chapter 19, verses 21 to 27a. Have pity on me. Have pity on me. O you, my friends, for the hand of God has touched me. Why do you, like God, pursue me, never satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were written down. Oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and with lead they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God. I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Hebrews, chapter 4, verses 1 to 16. Therefore, while the promise of entering his rest is still open, let us take care that none of you should seem to have failed to reach it. For indeed the good news came to us just as to them, but the message they heard did not benefit them, because they were not united by faith with those who listened. For we who have believed enter that rest, just as God has said, "As in my anger I swore, they shall not enter my rest." Though his works were finished at the foundation of the world. For in one place it speaks about the seventh day as follows, "And God rested on the seventh day from all his works." And again in this place it says, "They shall not enter my rest." Since therefore it remains open for some to enter it, and those who formerly received the good news fail to enter because of disobedience, again he sets a certain day, today, saying through David much later in the words already quoted, "Today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts." For if Joshua had given them rest, God would not speak later about another day. So then, a Sabbath rest still remains for the people of God. For those who enter God's rest also cease from their labors as God did from his. Let us therefore make every effort to enter that rest, so that no one may fall through such disobedience as theirs. Indeed, the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing until it divides soul from spirit, joints from marrow. It is able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart. And before him, no creature is hidden, but all are naked and laid bare to the eyes of the one to whom we must render an account. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Abba, Father, let me be yours and yours alone. May my will forever.
Brothers and sisters, our reading today, I'm very much tempted to talk about the Sabbath, which is right, which is not right. You know, that usual argument that a lot of us or many of us have. And we can go all the way into that to discuss day one, day seven, the Lord's day otherwise, and miss the point. Miss the point. And the point is simply a relationship with God. A relationship with God, a right one, a good one. And I say it very often because it is the message that God wants us to hear and understand, that we need to have a relationship with Him. In having that relationship with Him, we begin to understand and receive all other things. The writer talks about rest in God. And so you only come to understand or accept that rest in God when you have a relationship with God. Your confidence in God is there. Not that He's not there, but the way you see and approach and deal and relate to God is different. You're not anxious and constantly moving and on the go, but you find peace in God. And in this particular scripture talks about two forms of rest. The eternal rest, that space and being with God. But we're also reminded that there are some things we must do now in order to get there. And it's not a matter of just saying you believe, as they would have described the Pharisees at that time, believing based on what they see. But faith is about what you don't see as well. believing and trusting in it. And so we're called to have faith in God. We're called to rest and be at peace with God. And our struggle is the stillness. Our struggle is the surrender. I laugh because I have an uncle that says, if he goes to bed too early, he might miss what is going on. He might miss something big. Now understand, nothing is probably happening. But in his mind, he thinks that something might happen. And so he wants to stay up to see or to be present or to be a part of it so that he does not miss it. And it's funny when we have gatherings to see that he is struggling. He wants to sleep. He's falling asleep on himself and not even getting to see or be a part of the things that are going on. But he insists that he would not rest or would not stop because he does not want to miss anything. And for many of us, that's how we live. We want to continuously be in charge and be in control, and we think that we are in control of everything going wrong. And so we will not pause for a moment, because if we do, it will fall apart. What type of life is that? The writer reminds us that God even rested on the Sabbath. We don't even rest one day. And that rest is not, we're not talking about just stopping your regular movements. It's being still physically, being still mentally, and being still in your anxiety, being still in your trying to do it for yourself. Resting in Christ means, in God means allowing God to be God, allowing God to lead, allowing God to direct. But further to that, or added to that, or what goes with that is obedience. You see, when you allow God to lead and he says, go this way, resting in him requires you to do exactly what he says. And so the writer describes for us that it's not a matter of just saying you believe, for many Christians have said that they believe, but your actions must back up what you believe. And if you are aiming for rest, that rest first starts here. To receive that eternal rest, to receive that place, that rest first begins here. And it starts by having that relationship with God. And so to form that relationship, it doesn't start with believing, really. It starts with getting to know, reading your scripture, talking to God, asking God the questions that need to be asked, and allowing God to answer. Getting to know God means listening out for his words or whatever he's saying. Getting to know God means you have to be able to identify him in the spaces. So it means you need to study his word. His word helps you to see, to understand more about him. Get in groups that talk about God. Not badger God, not be dumb or try to decipher if he's real or not real, but encourage you to discover God on and people that can answer your questions. It's like, you know, there's always this meme that talks about if you want to be rich, line with rich people, that kind of thing. It's about the mentality. It is about the discussions that are had. It is about developing oneself. And so have those people around you that will encourage you that way to get to know God better. And in doing so, the more you walk, the more you learn. The more you walk, you learn to surrender. And it is in the surrendering to God that you find rest. Your anxieties go away. You realize that you don't even have to think about these things, for God will handle all of it for you. He will take care of it for you and with you. It's not that you carry less. It's not that things won't happen. It's that while going along life's roads, paths, and so forth, it does not bother you the same way, because you understand, you come to understand that God is with you. The lonely feeling goes away, and the trust expands. The faith and belief in God comes forward and leads you. And at the end of your days, your physical days here on earth, spend the rest with Christ. Spend the rest with God in heaven, in that place He has prepared. So again, I say, it is about a right relationship with God. And in making and working towards that right relationship, you find peace. You find rest here on earth, and eternal rest. Amen.
Still and know. surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior.
Now confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We continue in prayer. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach your leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us, your will may be done. O God, creator of heaven and earth, grant that as the crucified body of your dear Son was laid in the tomb and rested on this holy Sabbath, so we may await with him the coming of the third day and rise with him to newness of life, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I now invite us to offer our private petitions to God. Almighty God, help us to surrender ourselves to you. Change our hearts, O God, and give us hearts of flesh, hearts that care, hearts that love, hearts that come to know you. Make us true followers of yours. Give us courage to stand with you. Strengthen us to do what you have called us to do, to be obedient to your call, and to love one another the way you love us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons, in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. You have a wonderful day. God's richest blessings to all of you on this happy, holy Easter week. Have a wonderful day.